Truck's coming in tonight at 5 o'clock. Exactly. So me that be there by four. So it's time to set up and get ready. Y'all got our roles, remember? Distraction, guards, yep. Money,
Gino.
Get away.
Gino.
What?
Cameras.
Oh, run!
From the IHGN studios, it's Braves Beat.
Hey Braves, I'm Cardosi Gino. I mean Gino Cardosi. You didn't see anything.
And I'm Micah Solashak.
There's not a ton of news this week, but there is some, so let's get right into it.
Attention juniors. Junior Day of Service will be on September 26th. You will be volunteering from 9 o'clock to 11:30 and then will be treated to lunch at Elements Eatery. Make sure that you get all your paperwork in.
Congratulations to all our 2023 National Merit Scholarship semifinalists. Michael Chun, Tyler Wong, Krish Ranjan, Jude Jamison, Rohan Koshyan, Sophia Chen, and Jocelyn Gunati. Congratulations on this huge honor and good luck as you pursue finalist status.
September is the start of Oktoberfest. The traditional festival will be held until October 3rd. The world's largest folk festival is held every year in Bulgaria at this time and serves to no other purpose than to have be a few weeks of fun and games. So be sure to go out and enjoy some traditional German food and music this month.
Join the Reds in their last home game with a special event, Indian Hill Community Day at Great American Ballpark. On Sunday, September 24th at 1:40 p.m., Indian Hill families, members, and friends will come together to receive discounted tickets for the Reds game against the Pirates through a link that will be provided this week. This event is an opportunity to put a spotlight on the great community of Indian Hill and is put on by the Indian Hill Experienceship Program, so be sure to turn up.
Patrick and JC have this week's sports report for us. Take it away, guys.
Hello, Braves.
I'm JC.
And I'm Patrick Langworthy.
We have a lot of sports news this week, so let's get right into it.
The football team shut out Deer Park 35-0 at their own house. They play at Madeira tonight at 7 p.m. The theme is Hawaiian, so be there. Keep up the great work, boys.
Our cross-country team went to Florida last week and ran at the Lake Buena Vista Invitational in Orlando. Special shout-out to Harry Hong, who placed fourth in the overall in the 5K. Great job, Harry. They have two races next week, so good luck, guys.
The girls' field hockey team sadly lost to Olentangy, but bounced back and won 3-1 against Fairmont. They played Ursuline on Wednesday, and will have that score next week.
The boys' soccer team beat Bellbrook 3-0 last weekend and won against Reading High School 9-0 on their senior night. Thank you to all of our seniors for a perfect game. Great work, boys.
The volleyball team lost to Taylor 3-1 and played Marymount on Thursday. We'll have those scores next week. They also play Goshen on Saturday. Good luck.
The girls' tennis team continues to improve their undefeated streak by beating Mason, Summit, and Wyoming. They play against Taylor this week and we'll have those scores next time.
The girls' soccer team tied 1-1 against Archbishop Alter and played at Reading on Wednesday. We'll have those scores next week as well.
All right, that's it for sports scores this week. Good job and good luck to all of our athletes. Back to you guys at the news desk.
Thanks, JC and Patrick, and good luck to our sports teams heading into next week.
Our themes and events for Spirit Week are now official. Monday will be a PJ Day.
Tuesday will be Barbie Day.
Wednesday is Country Club versus Country.
Thursday is Adam Sandler Day.
And then finally, Friday is Whiteout. There will also be an Instagram contest throughout the week. The winning grade will get Kona Ice Truck at the end of the week. All right, Braves, that's all the news we have for this week. Be sure to follow us on Twitter, subscribe to us on YouTube, and email us with any school updates. And remember,
stay classy, Indian Hill.
Oh, hey, guys. So we had some last-minute dates come in from student government, so I'm just going to read those off real quick. So for next week, as far as our festivities go, we've got Monday is our Powder Puff and our movie night. Powder Puff will start at 5:15, and then our movie will start at, I believe it's 9:30 now, so ignore the flyers. It's not right. Wednesday is our panel painting starting at 2:50, and we'll go till 6 o'clock at night. Friday, of course, is all of our fun stuff, so we've got our pep rally in the middle of the day, our parade, and then the football game, which will start at Tomahawk Stadium at 7 o'clock, so be sure to be there. Saturday is our dance from 8 to 10:30.
Hello, I'm here with Mr. Millard. Mr. Millard, how are you doing today?
I'm doing great. How are you doing?
I'm swell. What is your favorite song?
Well, you know, Brooke, it really changes day by day. Mm-hmm. So it's really not my favorite song. It's really always just sort of my favorite song of today. Mm-hmm.
And it could Which is, be what is it today?
My favorite song of the hour.
Okay.
Yeah. But right now, I'm thinking You Little Fool by Elvis Costello.
Okay.
That's my favorite song right now.
Hello, I am here with Mr. Pigowski. What is your favorite song?
Once in a Lifetime by the Talking Heads.
How did I get here?
Nice.
The one and only Mr. Phelps. Mr. Phelps, what's your favorite song?
Violent Femmes, Blister in the Sun.
Like a blister in the sun, let me go wild. Big hands, you know you're the one.
Mr. Walter, what is your favorite song?
So when I was in middle school in 1980, I heard Feels So Good by Chuck Mangione, played on his trumpet, but it really it's a flugelhorn. Yes, instrumental jazz, about 10 minutes long, and I was hooked.
So that's your favorite song?
That's my favorite song.
Okay. I'm here with Mr. Nomadeo. What is your favorite song?
Brooke, that's an easy one. It is Pearl Jam's State of Love and Trust. I want to listen to it. 1992 singles soundtrack. Go check it out.
Go check it out. 5, 6, 7, 8.
Go.